Let's talk through this spot instance walkthrough architecture. In this first example here, we have AWS Cloud 9, and this is really the docking station where I'd like to do commands, launch other instances, really do interactive things with the AWS platform. So if you wanted to programmatically, you could go through here and launch a spot instance using the AWS API, or you also could separately in the AWS console, you could go through and launch a spot instance. Once you go through that setup, the key components of launching a spot instance are, one, you will need to bid on an instance, just like you would bid on an auction. You can bid what price you'd like to pay to launch a virtual machine. It can be up to 90% off, so it's a huge savings, and I'd recommend this for many people experimenting on the AWS platform. Once you do that, really there's only a couple key things to take care of other than the size of the virtual machine. One of them is the security group. And why is this so important? Well, what's important about the security group is this is what port you can talk to when you launch the machine. So this could be, let's say, port 80 if you were going to run a web service, or port 22 if later you wanted to go through here and SSH in to control the machine, which is what we'll do in another video. So in this example, I would want to open up port 22 in the security group, or else I couldn't SSH in. Another component of the SSH mechanism is that you'll have to use a PIM file, and this will be the SSH key that will allow me to connect to that spot instance. Finally, if I wanted to do a separate API call, let's say I wanted to do natural language processing or, you know, some kind of a image recognition service call, I would have to assign a role to this spot instance so that it had the ability to make those connections. So really, there's only a few moving pieces here to care about. Again, it's the bid, the security group, and the roles, and the SSH key PIM file. And then this is why I would recommend Cloud 9, is that you can make that SSH connection from the Cloud 9 environment. And that's why it's so powerful, is that instead of having to worry about your laptop and, you know, controlling everything from there, if you keep a AWS Cloud 9 instance available and you shut it down when you're not using it, what's nice about it is you can control lots of spot instances from this one instance, and you have a reliable, you know, essentially transfer station to control other parts of the AWS infrastructure. So let's go ahead and get started with that right now.